I spy with my eagle eye my audience. And here they are sitting and paying attention to their host, which is me. I have a box belonging to a game called Eagle Eye, which is related to I Spy. Plus, I have a card about technologies used to spy on and record what's going on at eagle nests. The movie we will go over is about spies, and no, it's not about watching or eavesdropping, it's about secret agents. The movie is called Spies in Disguise. Will this mission result in a successful operation, or will the movie just be pooping everywhere like a real pigeon? Time to start the mission on investigating this movie.
What's wrong with being confident?
The story. The first part of this mission is to go over what the movie is all about. Super spy Lance Sterling and scientist Walter Beckett are almost exact opposites. Lance is smooth, suave, and debonair. Walter is not. But what Walter lacks in social skills, he makes up for in smarts and invention, creating the awesome gadgets Lance uses on his epic missions. But when events take an unexpected turn, Walter and Lance suddenly have to rely on each other in a whole new way. And if this odd couple can't learn to work as a team, the whole world is in peril. My audience wants me to comment about the film. I say that it's a good thing that Lance has been inadvertently turned into a pigeon to avoid arrest when he is framed by Killian. Although, Lance would be unable to fight bad people due to his small size. The animation. We now investigate how the animation and design is created. The character designs of this film are similar to the character designs used in Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs from 2009, Arthur Christmas from 2011, Hotel Transylvania from 2012, Storks from 2016, and Smallfoot from 2018. All of which, except for Storks and Smallfoot, were made by Sony Animation. Agent Sterling has a tattoo of the U.S. Marine Corps emblem of the eagle, globe, and anchor on the left side of his chest above his heart. He also has a high fade haircut, which is a common style in the Marines. Those clearly indicate that Agent Sterling is a Marine veteran. Even though Peter Chernin is credited as producer and not his Chernin Entertainment Prodco, this is CE's first animated film. Well, that wasn't a lot about the animation. The characters. Now we have to ask about the characters. Lance Sterling is the world's best spy who ends up on the run, who ends up being framed as the mastermind behind the drone attacks. In order to avoid being detected, he is inadvertently transformed into a pigeon by Walter's concealment concoction. During his mission with Walter, he learns the importance of teamwork and peace. He is voiced by Will Smith, who also voiced Oscar the Cleaner Rats from Shark Tale.
This is a vile waste of taxpayer dollars.
This is like the best idea ever, all right? It's a sure thing, guaranteed cash extravaganza.
Then there's Walter Beckett, who is a young scientist at the same agency Lance works at. His non-violent yet still effective gadgets are ridiculed by fellow scientists and agents alike. He graduated from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology when he was 15 and helps Sterling disappear after he gets framed. He is voiced by Tom Holland, who also voiced Jip the dog from Doolittle and Ian Lightfoot the elf from Onward. We also have Marcy Capel, who is a skilled security forces agent who mostly pursues Lance Sterling throughout the majority of the movie after Lance was framed for betraying the U.S. government. She has a strict code of following every rule as well as being no-nonsense and straightforward. Although appearing strict and stern on the outside, Marcy is actually nice and compassionate deep down. This is evident during her mission at Venice, where she comforted Walter after telling him that his mother sacrificed herself trying to protect her people. Killian is a powerful technology-based terrorist mastermind with a left bionic arm. He was attacked by Lance and the spy network in Kyrgyzstan. The attack caused his left hand and half of Killian's face to burn off, forcing him to repair both of them with technology. The main character, Lance Sterling, may have a metaphorical connection to the former president of Nintendo, Reggie. The main characters' names are Walter and Lance. Perhaps this is a homage to Walter Lance, the animator who introduced Woody Woodpecker to audiences. The character, Eyes, who has red hair, is voiced by Karen Gillan, who also has red hair, and unusually speaks with her native Scottish accent. Allow me to end this investigation with comments. The film is inspired by Lucas Martel's animated short, Pigeon Impossible, from 2009. The hotel where Lance first tracks Kimura is a real place, the Blue Bay Hotel and Resort Grand Esmeralda, and it is really located in Playa del Carmen, Mexico. Several of the principal actors, Ben Mendelsohn, Karen Gillan, Tom Holland, and Will Smith, have portrayed either superheroes or supervillains in comic book films. Tom Holland and Karen Gillan previously co-starred in Avengers Infinity War from 2018 and Avengers Endgame from 2019. Both Will Smith and Karen Gillan share a movie connection, the late Robin Williams. Smith, who voices Lance Sterling, played the genie in the live-action remake of Aladdin, the same role that Williams played in the original animated Aladdin, whilst Gillan, who voices Eyes, played Martha/Ruby Roundhouse in both Jumanji Welcome to the Jungle from 2017 and Jumanji The Next Level from 2019, both sequels to the original 1995 film Jumanji, of which Williams starred in also. This was released the same year as Spider-Man Far From Home. Both films are produced by companies owned by the Walt Disney Company, Marvel Studios, and Blue Sky. Star Tom Holland have an African-American super spy ally, Nick Fury and Lance Sterling, have a fight in Venice and shows the Rialto Bridge, have the villain use an army of killer drones, and have Ben Mendelsohn as someone who impersonates the super spy ally. The film's original release date was January 18, 2009, but was then pushed back to April 19, 2019. It got pushed back again to September 13, 2019, and it got pushed back once more to Christmas Day on December 25th. Steve Odenkirk was considered for the director of this film. This is the third theatrically released fully animated film to be composed by Theodore Shapiro after The Pirates, Band of Misfits from 2012 and Captain Underpants, the first epic movie from 2017. The last animated film of the 2010s to be shot in the 2.35:1 aspect ratio and the last theatrically released animated film of the 2010s. Mission accomplished. Thank you all for reviewing this movie with me. I'm going home now, so I better pack up my things. Enjoy all the gadgets, thrills, and action!